What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new English Beat. In today's lesson, we're going to learn 10 super useful expressions that I like a lot. I'm sure they will help you be more fluent and sound more natural when speaking English. Are you ready? So take a notebook and let's get started. The first expression we're going to learn today is I owe you one. I owe you one. You can use this expression when somebody does you a favor and you want to thank them by saying that you would be happy to return the favor in the future. En castellano sería te debo una. And now let's look at two examples. The first one, thanks for giving me a lift to the airport. I owe you one. And another example, thanks for helping me out. I owe you one. Let's move on to our expression number two. It's up to you. It's up to you. It means you decide, I don't mind, whatever. En castellano, lo que quieras. And now let's look at two examples. The first one, shall we go to Japanese or Italian restaurant tonight? It's up to you. It's like, you choose, you decide. And another example, we can meet up on Monday or Tuesday. It's up to you. Let's continue our expression number three, sleep on it. It means you need some time to make a decision, to think it over. En castellano sería consultarlo con la almohada. And now let's look at some examples. The first one, you don't need to decide right now. Sleep on it and let me know when you're ready. And one more example, I'll sleep on your offer. Let's continue our expression number four, it's on me. It's on me. You can use this expression when you have a drink or a meal with a friend, and when you finish and get your check, you want to pay for everything. You don't want to split the check. So you can say, it's on me. En castellano sería, te invito. But be careful, in English, it's not correct to say, I invite you. You need to say, it's on me, or there are other options. For example, you can say, it's my treat, let me treat you, it's my shout, I'm getting this, or I'll get this. And now let's look at some examples. The first one, it's on me this time. And one more example, let's go Dutch. No, keep your money, it's on me. Let's continue our expression number five, don't get me wrong. Don't get me wrong. It's level C2. And you can use this expression when somebody might misunderstand you because maybe you're criticizing something and you want to make sure that what you said is clear. En castellano, no me entiendas mal. And now let's look at some examples. The first one, don't get me wrong. I'd love to travel with you, but right now I'm very busy. And the second example, don't get me wrong. I think your job is interesting, but it wouldn't be suitable for me. Let's continue with another C2 expression, over the top. Over the top. We use this expression when something is extremely outrageous, exaggerated, or excessive. En castellano, un poco demasiado o exagerado. And now two examples. The first one, do you think my outfit is a bit over the top? And another example, their Christmas decorations are way over the top this year. Way means very. Our expression number seven, over the line. Over the line. It means that something is beyond what is considered appropriate or acceptable. En castellano diríamos pasarse tres pueblos o pasarse de la raya. And now let's look at two examples. The first one, sorry, I said a few things that were over the line. And one more example, his rude and impolite behavior in the meeting was over the line. Let's continue our expression number eight, on the house. On the house. If you have something on the house, it means that it's given to you free by business. En castellano, invita a la casa. The first example, the drinks are on the house. And the second example, the dessert was on the house to make up for the slow service. The phrasal verb to make up for something means to compensate. Second to last expression, it's not even close. It's not even close. We use this expression when we guess something and our guess is not correct. En castellano, ni se acerca ni se aproxima. And now, two examples. The first one, guess who I ran into yesterday. James? Not even close. My ex-boss. And one more example, have you picked your next summer destination? Italy? Not even close. I'm going to Thailand. And last but not least, the expression kudos. Kudos. It can be kudos for something, but you can also say kudos on something. The British pronunciation kudos, kudos, and the American kudos, kudos. And it means well done, congrats, in castellano, enhorabuena, bien hecho, felicidades. And now, two examples. The first one, kudos for the brilliant presentation. And the last example, kudos for passing your driving test. So that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this English bit and these 10 super useful expressions that I like a lot. If you did, don't forget to give this video a like, to subscribe to the channel and connect with me on Instagram. Enjoy the last days of this year and see you in 2020 with more English bits. Thanks for watching and see you next year. Ciao!